When the announcement for the new Apple iPad Pro came, I was really excited. You know, I already have an Apple iPad Pro 11-inch from last year, and it's fantastic. So hearing that Apple not only put mini LED into the new 12.9-inch model, but a freaking M1 chip that you can currently see in their full-on computers, I was blown away. I thought it was nuts. I mean, the previous Apple iPad Pro was already insanely fast, smooth, shockingly capable, and feels super snappy with that 120Hz ProMotion display. There's a reason why it takes people 5 years before they replace their iPad. So the idea of going even higher than this one seems really insane to me. So I had to get one for myself, and I figure I'd go for the 16GB model because Apple surely must be planning to do something mind-blowing with all that power. Usually they increase things by 2GB, but 10GB? That's nuts. They have something in store, right? I also felt justified paying more for a 12.9-inch model despite preferring an 11-inch model because, well, you gotta have that mini LED technology. Oh, and a new Magic Keyboard since the 11-inch model won't, This is starting to cost a lot of money. But you know, I bit the bullet and paid for the insane price for a tablet, but hey, maybe this tablet that's a computer will be able to run Final Cut Pro soon. Well, give me some of the things that I can't get on Apple's traditional computers, like 120Hz display, a touchscreen with the Apple Pencil, which is really nice, and the insane contrast ratios from a fantastic display. So the day comes, it's delivered, I unbox it, and wow, this thing is way bigger than the 11-inch model. But you know what? I kind of like it. In fact, it makes the 11-inch model look really small now, so I suppose I can look past how much more room it takes up in my bag, even with this really big Magic Keyboard and, unfortunately, all the crazy scuffs this thing gets. And probably you shouldn't get the white keyboard. I have no idea why that sounds like a good idea. It probably will get really nasty. That is, unless you get a skin from channel sponsor Dbrand to cover up all that and customize a little bit. But you know what? You can protect more than just your Magic Keyboard from getting all scuffed up. It can protect the back of your iPad, protecting it from scratches, fingerprints, and personalize it a bit. I mean, you spent almost a grand for it, so put a skin on it. Check it out. There's a link in the description. And thanks to Dbrand for sponsoring a portion of this video. Anyways, I turn it on and that Face ID camera is right in the wrong spot still. That's kind of a bummer. But you know, I really like that center stage feature for video calls and just the ability to have an ultra-wide camera, further widening the gap between the cameras on Apple's iOS devices from their macOS devices. I don't know why that's a thing, but to be fair though, that's probably not the reason to get this iPad. So, you know, I take a look at this amazing display, and I'm not sure why it kind of seems the same as the last model. I navigate around it and I really like that 120Hz ProMotion display. It's really smooth and fast, just like last year's model. Is it a little bit brighter? Honestly, I can't tell. You know what? I'm gonna bring up a movie. That'll do it. Oh yeah, I can definitely see that now. The blacks are blacker and it's not all washed out like the last model. And the contrast is really great. And the old one looks kind of, you know, well, it looks fine. It's still pretty good, but you know, just washed out. That's great and all for when I watch a movie on my iPad. I mean, I guess on the rare chance that I do watch a movie on my iPad, it's nice to have a 12.9-inch screen instead of an 11-inch screen for when I do that. Oh, editor Brandon here. There's been a lot of discussion around the display issues on the iPad Pro 12.9-inch model and its mini LEDs. I actually noticed this on my own without hearing it from everyone else and not being aware of the conversation that was already happening when I was performing a video test on it by going to YouTube and using the Dolby Atmos Showcase video to see how good it looked. I mean, mini LED, it should look great with this, right? Well, when I adjusted the volume, well, this huge white line shows up across the screen that was glaring. Apparently obvious to the naked eye. So no, it's not a camera trick. I just saw it with my bare eyes. I even tested it at a lower brightness and well, you could still see it, but to a lesser extent. While I've heard of people seeing this blooming issue showing up in multiple other places, I honestly don't notice it that much or at all in regular use. In every other situation so far, I think the screen looks great. If there is some blooming when I'm using it normally, I really don't see it. If I'm gonna be honest, I'd have to look for it, which I think is a good sign and a reason to not hold off on buying the iPad Pro 12.9-inch model if you're planning to buy it anyways. All right, back to the rest of the video. Ah, I got it. That M1 chip though, that's a big deal, right? So I ran the test and wow, it's actually performing twice as fast in multi-core and metal scores compared to last year's iPad, and it's even doing better than the MacBook Air? That's insane. I mean, it's insane to see the numbers, but I honestly can't tell much of a difference between the last gen iPad Pro and this one in terms of practical use. I mean, this one was already overpowered for what it was doing. So maybe for video editing, yeah. It's running insanely smooth and ripping through the Sony A7S III footage, but my last iPad Pro blazed through that like nothing too. Heck, even the iPad Air can do that. Oh, I got it. The bigger screen is nicer for looking at docs and stocks like on Public, which I'm constantly chatting with amazing people on and using it all the time, and where you can get a free stock up to $50 if you sign up with the link down below in the description. It's honestly one of my favorite places. Check it out. It's free money. But why would I need a mini LED display for my stocks and my documents? That seems a little bit obsessive, but I like being able to hook up an external monitor, hook up storage devices to it, docs and more. That's actually pretty awesome. I just wish that this could do more. Ooh, dang, so over $2,200 after taxes, and it doesn't feel like much of an upgrade. Last year's iPad Pro was so dang good and so capable that it felt like anything I threw at it was like throwing a small rock into a lake. It hardly did anything. This? It feels like throwing a rock into an ocean. So why would someone buy this? Why would I even keep it? Well, it all comes down to what happens in the future. Will Apple release abilities and apps that can wield all of this power? The idea of having Final Cut Pro on this large, beautiful screen in a touch-friendly interface with the Apple Pencil and the ability to rip through it with tons of layers of footage, effects, and more, that would finally make this feel like an upgrade. Having a full-on Photoshop app that brings you the power of their desktop app, but with the precision and ability and possibilities that come with an Apple Pencil would finally make this feel like an upgrade. Being able to use a LiDAR camera to scan an object or your surrounding and bring it into an app that allows you to create interactive VR, AR experiences or even CG movies from an iPad, that would make this feel like an upgrade. But at this very moment when I'm filming, it can't really do that. It's only a bet, a dream, a hope. It might not even happen soon or at all. It would be silly to get this right now, unless you're in a weird spot like me where my job is to make these videos for you. And if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. Or maybe you just need to upgrade after having your iPad for years, or you don't even have one at all. It makes sense then to buy an iPad. Otherwise, for now, you should wait until it can actually do something to make this feel like an upgrade. Because for now, it's just an iPad.